templates. Templates are everywhere. They are widely used in email and web apps because they save tons of time and effort. But are they always safe to use? Hey, welcome to Security Bytes. Today we learn about template object injection. Our research shows that this critical vulnerability occurs in the wild and not only affects the template rendering APIs, but also the applications consuming those APIs. Let's take it step by step though and start from the basics. Behind the scenes, templates are provided with content in the form of objects. With template rendering APIs, also known as template rendering engines, used as intermediaries to insert the content into the templates. The impact of this flow depends on the underlying rendering engine used. We have verified through past cases that attackers can take full control of a system via remote code execution. Even in cases where remote code execution is not possible, attackers often use template injection as the basis for numerous other attacks, such as cross-site scripting and arbitrary file read that we covered in our previous very exciting episode. Today in our demo, we feature MailTrain. MailTrain is an open source newsletter software that is great for sending emails to millions of subscribers. For this to happen, MailTrain's rendering API will be given an object to process. This object contains what is blank on the email template, such as a subscriber's email address and first name. This vulnerability results from two common template features. First, when the object that is passed to the rendering engine is an arbitrary object. Specifically, an object that instead of just containing the absolutely necessary data to serve its purpose, has the ability to supply additional data or any data to the rendering engine. By allowing such an object to enter the rendering API, applications can inadvertently introduce malicious behavior by overwriting both the configuration keys and values of the engine. This happens due to the way the API merges the incoming data with internal settings. The second feature is when templates are open to customization in an intentional attempt to offer richer functionality. This is very common between content management systems, but it drastically amplifies the attack surface if not designed with security in mind. In this real-world example, our researcher Agustin Gianni demonstrated that MailTrain was vulnerable to template object injection. As explained, he was able to supply an object via URL that overrides the internal configuration of the template. This happens because of the function on screen router.get, populating the object data by parsing a user-supplied URL. Agustin used the following URL as proof of concept that pops up the classic cross-site scripting alert on the victim's machine. A real attacker could have used the same technique in a phishing email, where a malicious URL would trigger the execution of a script aiming towards critical impact. In the same way, the following URL can be used to show the contents of a file unintentionally. A mitigation in the context of MailTrain would be to only accept objects that contain the data the template rendering engine expects, and only accept those objects. Users will be able to only influence the presentation element, and this isolation will make it impossible for a malicious actor to intervene with the logic. However, this is sometimes unavoidable due to business requirements. Leave a comment below to let us know which vulnerabilities to cover next. In the meantime, stay in the loop by following us on Twitter. Remember, quality code is a QR code.